Have you found a mistake on the drawing? Is there any discrepancy between two other trades? My name is Greg and welcome to SiteEng. In today's video, guys, we're gonna do the RFI and I'm gonna explain what it is and how to do it. We're gonna use for it the two drawings I overlaid the other day, and guys, just make sure you're gonna watch till the end because I wanna show you why the information on the drawing is the very first thing you should go through. So let's go and have a look at that RFI.
So guys, in the last video, we actually overlaid this two drawings, general arrangement, the structural drawing here for the concrete. So what we're going to be setting out and doing. And then we got M&E drawing here. And what we're going to do today now, because we see some discrepancy here in between the penetration showing on the structural drawing and in between the M&E, we're going to raise an RFI here. And as you can see here, we got bathroom here, so that penetration makes sense. And this penetration here next to the toilet bowl makes sense as well, but we're missing this on the structural drawing. And instead of this, guys, we got it actually opening showing in the middle of the door here. That's why we're going to ask the question to confirm the position of the drawing. And then, guys, just stay till the end of it, because I'm going to show you why the reading of the notes and the reading the drawing, the information on the drawing, is the most important thing just before you start doing anything else. But this RFI, guys, it's an example what we would do if we had the information like this, and how we would raise RFI if we needed. So what I would typically do, guys, because the language for the engineer's language is the drawing. So I always try to attach the drawing to the RFI I'm sending when I'm going to explain quickly what I need, and depends of the situation, obviously, we're going to be describing. I always attach the drawing, so I would take this one, for instance. Let's take only one penetration here, and we're going to ask here, as we see clearly discrepancy here. So I would mark it like that, and I would, so I'd go like this, and I would just ask, maybe please confirm position of the penetration. What I would do, obviously, I'm going to just leave it white so I'm going to be clearly visible. I'm going to make the font bigger as well, and I even do the line, maybe I just do black and a little bit thicker as well, and I'm just going to work a little bit on my arrow. So that's what I would actually attach to my RFI, guys, that way it is, so you can clearly see when you open this drawing, you see it's too overlaid. So you see the red one is the structural drawing here, and the light blue, we overlaid the M&E, which shows the architect drawing as well here, showing you all the layout for the building here. So once you open this, you clearly know, please confirm position of the penetration. You can see something is wrong. That's what I would attach to my RFI, guys. But what I do myself, obviously, it depends what job you're going to be working on, as some people, they're not going to even speak with you till you actually raise the official RFI. But typically what I try to get, I'm sending the emails, and I'm going to try to get the answer just before that. And then please remember that responding for the RFI is typically 7 or it might be even 14 days, depending on the job you're doing. So they might actually have more time for the answer. Then you need actually to install this. We assuming a goodwill here, and solving the problem is the most important thing. So I think we can communicate well. And as I always said, the communication is the key, guys. If you're working on site, communication on site is the key for you. And then you can see there was a miscommunication here between the design and M&E, definitely. So that's another one. That's the communication problem here. There was some discrepancy. But as I said, at the end of the video, you're going to find out it wasn't that bad, really. So that would be the drawing I would attach. And also, if I would send the email, I typically send the email as well with a question. I would probably just take the snapshot of it. Maybe just so we're going to see the grid lines here. I would take the snapshot, just Control C, and I'm going to put mail. I would just paste it in, just clearly say, what's going on here, guys? Just can you confirm? But to make it official, guys, just the RFI, I would put here the text for it. And it's going to be dependent what platform you're going to be using, or if you're going to be sending just the RFI through the email, and then you're going to be keeping some record of it. Or like A-Site, I showed it the other day, you can actually raise an RFI through the A-Site or through some platforms you're using. On my last job, actually, there was a few other platforms, and the procedure was a little bit difficult, a little bit time consuming, I would say. Maybe not difficult, but sometimes people just overthinking and making simple stuff too complicated, really. So what we would do in this case, guys, we probably ask for the penetration. So there is a discrepancy between structural drawing and we're gonna put the number of the drawing here, obviously, and the M&E drawing, M&E drawing number of the drawing we want to hear, and make sure we're using the latest revision. And then there's discrepancy. We got a drawing at that, so we can just write please confirm position of the penetrations or issue an updated drawing, and then please see attach. I would personally leave it like that, guys. Once you're gonna read this, if you'll be designer, please, there is a discrepancy between structural drawing drawing number and the level, obviously, and then between the M&E, and then please confirm position of the penetration, so we know it's a penetrations, and then issue an updated drawing, or confirm. So, and then obviously the RFI you're gonna need the number as well, so you can keep a tracker of it. So that'll be, let's say, that'll be our RFI 001, and the title for it would be penetration position discrepancy. And that's it, guys. That's all you need. That's how you raise in RFI, so don't be afraid of it. I remember when I was doing this stuff for the first time, I wasn't sure, you know, I was writing a few times the same thing, and it's always like that. So it's normal, guys. Everyone go through it. Every single thing you're gonna do the first time, you're not sure how to do it. So I think that's gonna help you. Just don't be shy, just don't be afraid of it. Just raise it and then try to explain the best as you can. And as I said, the drawing is the language of the engineers. Once you mark it, it's clearly known, and everyone knows what's all about, you know. Once they're gonna open the drawing, you can see clearly something is wrong. So you don't want to spend two times explaining in between grid line CM and CN there is a penetration. It's no point of doing that, guys. You just want to, as we are engineers, we want to take it the least time, and then we're going to explain it the best. So we're going to have an answer and we're going to have a results, but using the minimum time to get this. So guys, that was the example of the RFI. If we need it, guys, and that's why I told you at the end of the video, I'm going to show you why the reading of the information provided on the drawing is so important, because in real life we wouldn't even ask that RFI. But as I said, that was the example. That how you're going to be raising your RFIs. So as you can see here, I got a note here, the big note for setting out coordinates for services within slab referred to architect's drawing, guys. So this actually tells you all this penetration shouldn't be set out as per this drawing, and there's no dimensions actually to it. And this is a little bit confusing, guys, because some people, they just bring in the GA drawing to the controller, and then later on the slab they setting out as per the drawing, as a penetration they got here. So this is a little bit confusing. Maybe if I would be the designer, I wouldn't even put them here, because this might actually cause some problems. So then we're gonna go to the architect's drawing, and then you see we got a penetration same as shown on that M&E drawing. We got a penetration which makes sense here. We got the bathrooms here, and all the penetrations here actually as they should be. And as you can see here, we don't have a clear setting out in terms of position of the grid lines. So what we would do, guys, if we would be doing setting out on for the slabs, we would have to take the information from this architect drawing using the CAD and just bring them on our structural drawing. A little bit of work in preparation for the setting out, or maybe that will be your senior engineer job if you're going to be too busy to doing setting out. So guys, that's why I'm saying this is very important to read the information here provided on the drawing, as this might be confusing here, and that will be actually our error if you set up as per this drawing. So that's our job as well, to keep an eye on this and ask the question if there is a discrepancy. But if there is a clear information what we should use, we need to bring that information together for ourselves, and we need to make sure we're going to do it right, guys. So I think that will be all in today's video, and if you like it, please don't forget to leave a thumbs up, guys. This helping to grow this channel and help me a lot, and shows me that whatever I'm doing here makes sense. And then, guys, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel as well if you didn't do it, and then follow my LinkedIn page. They're gonna be more and more coming now, I promise you that, and you don't want to miss it. So see you next time.